live your dreams and fight for what you want. Because if you don't, then who will? But I wake up and nothing's wrong. Just get ready for work, 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 work. To me, I'll be work, 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 work. You see me do me dirt, 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 dirt. So tell me about that work. So I cut the bangs. This is one side, this is the other, because I don't like gluing this on my head. I'm not a beauty guru or anything, but maybe I'll become one. But I cut it, guys. Look, so you can tell the difference. Combed, not combed, cut, not cut. Now let's pray that this side turns out the same. Get out and enjoy the sun, okay? To my fellow Texan citizens, go do something nice for yourself. Get out and be beautiful. Get out and enjoy the sun. Even if you're not in Texas, please stick it out and enjoy the sun, because why not? Why not? Sparkle, shine, like a diamond. Total, total. It feels so funny just recording, watching everybody stare at me. Can't be ashamed. Can't be scared all your life. You have to get up, do something, and try. Because why not? And if not you, then who? Perfect. Do you guys want some? Do you want some? Want some? Have some. Some bread. Some quantities. Okay. So I just want to show y'all what I got besides this. I got this cute little puzzle for Liz. Hint, Texas. Okay, because she loves Texas so much. Okay, guys. So first, let me tell you my agenda. My agenda when I went, I'm not changing because I don't want to. Just let the light shine, okay? But my agenda going into the bookstore was just to find like books about nature. I wrote last month that I need to get more into my feminine side, right? So I wrote down a list of different books that I want, like nature, hopeless romantic books, poetry, pretty much like anything that helps me get more in tune with my feminine side. So I picked up this godly book because there were so many spiritual books in that store. I went to Half Price Bookstores. There were so many spiritual books in that store that used to be a part of my lifestyle. I got this book. It's like a daily affirmation book kind of vibe. It's called God is in the Small Stuff and All That Matters. Stop worrying and invite God into the details of your life. I have been trying to invite God different kinds of ways into my life, and I love that it has this cute get into it. This is a different part of my spirituality, okay? So I'm glad that I got that. We're gonna save this one for last. So I got an actual poetry book, okay? And this book is called Sound the Deep Waters, Women's Romantic Poetry in the Victorian Age. For people who don't really know me like that, I am super obsessed with this kind of, like this, the Victorian age of life. I'm super obsessed with like the Roman times. Like I just love the Egyptian times of like diamonds and pearls and just What do they call that when you chop the heads off? What is that called?
Guillotine.
A guillotine, like that whole entire era. Like, what is it, medieval times? I'm super obsessed. So once I saw this, I was like, oh, I have to have it. And it's my favorite color, green. So, and I just opened it up to like a random page and I just started reading and I saw something like this and I was just like, oh my God. I love the way they write with the little feather pens. Like, I just love it so much. And they make like their own perfumes and their little, it's just great. Okay, so the next book I got, I kind of read a few pages of this one. It's called Bebe Moore Campbell, What You Owe Me. So first, what caught my eye was the makeup, the cute little compact mirror and the lipstick. And then I see this girl in the background. I'm like, oh, okay. The author is African American. So this is a book based on a true story on how there was two women in like the Civil War age and whatnot. The main character, she moved from Texas to California. She moved with this lady who survived the Holocaust. So you have like two major times, the Civil War and the Holocaust, and two African American women. They started a lipstick company, and the lady that's from Texas, I believe she died. Don't get me wrong, I don't want to misconstrue the story, but once I read it, I will definitely inform you guys. They started this makeup company, and one of them died, and then took the other person that was still alive, took over the whole entire business, but she was like doing like some weird trickery like stuff going on. And so the lady who died first had a daughter, so she ended up finding out about the medical stuff and business that they had. She ended up finding out that the lady pretty much like took the business and ran, so she went and tried to go savor it and whatnot, and there was just a whole lot of drama and everything going on. So that's why I picked this book up, and I love that the book is thick. I love that the book is like a hardback, so just in case, or not just in case, but whenever I get my bookshelf, that I can take this part off and have it in my library as something like this. I love this. I left my bookmarks at the store. No, I didn't leave them. She forgot to put them in the bag because I purchased them, okay? But anyways, okay? Because as long as I got the books, bookmarks can be replaceable. Okay, so this is another book. Okay. It is called Women on Top. It is a Nancy Friday book. And it says how real life has changed women's sexual fantasies. I didn't really dive too deep into this, but I read this little piece right here. And it actually talks about a lot. So I'm gonna give this a little try, okay? I love little fantasy books. I love books about sensuality. I love books about, you know, different women opinions and what they experience in life. So that just kind of like, I don't know, sunk me a little bit because there's so many different things that women experience in life. There's so many different women expressing how they cope with sex, if it was good, if it was bad, and I just love reading ratings and reviews and stuff like that. And I ended up getting this book because I used to read things like this when I was little, when I was in high school and middle school. This is called Generation Girl, and it is stage fright. So I don't really know what it's about, but this helps me stay kind of keened into like my teenage girl, that inner child, you know, keeping like hope alive, okay? Because, you know, this world is just so cruel that we forget to be young women. We forget how it feels to feel young. We forget how it feels to feel alive. And then in my personal opinion, I felt more alive in high school than anything. What about you? Jemro, please, the last book.
Put it up.
I purchased. Dun, dun, dun. Okay, I don't even need to explain why I got this book. I really don't need to explain why I got this book. It's just self-explanatory. But this pretty much is this lady interviewing Marilyn Monroe and knowing a lot of stuff about Marilyn Monroe that the world really didn't know and things like that. So I'm gonna read it. She knew a lot of secrets. She knew a lot of things about Marilyn Monroe that the movies didn't show and things like that. There was another book that I picked up But I ended up asking the ladies that were in there. It was a worker and a customer. And I was like, guys, if you could choose out of this book and another book that I was holding in my hand, it was white. I said, which one would you choose? And they chose this one. Funny thing is, when I first walked into the store, I was like, I hope I find a Marilyn Monroe book. They had like vinyls. Yeah, they had like vinyls. They had movies. They had DVDs. They had CDs. They had these crazy collectibles items. It was just absolutely insane. And I was just like, I really do genuinely hope I find a Marilyn Monroe book. And the first, when you first walk into the store, as you guys saw, when you first walk into the store, it was like performing arts and stuff like that. And I just like walked past it because when I went on the aisle, it was like more of like bands, like different band groups and things like that. And I was just like, I don't want any books about bands. So I just walked past it and I went to like the little puzzles and stuff. And that's how I found that little thing for Liz. And honestly, I just wanted to look around the whole entire store because I've been in that area to where I would see the half price bookstore, but I never went inside. So I made my rounds around the whole entire store to make sure I picked up at least one poetry book, one hopeless romantic story, either a horror story or a suspense, some kind of thriller or true crime. I made sure I picked up a godly book, or a spiritual book, sort of say, same thing. And then I made my rounds back to the performing arts because I thought she would maybe have like a section of the store by herself. So, yeah, and then I came back and I saw that and I was just like, ah! Thank you, God. I'm super excited to read, but yes. Thank you for spending my Friday with me. I hope that you come back for more because I'm probably going to do these every Friday. I think that would be really great. Even if I just pick up one or two books from the store, I think I'm going to try to make that a habit because I wanted to purchase 100 books before the year is over. So I purchased 6 today and maybe next Friday I'll purchase some more. Maybe the Friday after that. So maybe I'll do like every other Friday or like the first Friday of the month. I don't know. I'll figure it out. But I just encourage you ladies to get into reading books, get into reading stories, get into, you know, your feminine side, get into that romantic side of yourself. It's good to fantasize about life. It's good to have hope about something. It's good to have a story that's not your own. It's good to hear other ladies' experiences, okay? So until next time, thank you for attending Sparkle University and I catch you later. Guys, I feel so bad because I actually got another book that I just found in the car. I'm not going to say it must have slipped out the bag, but it has slipped out the bag and the bookmarks are right there. This is one. Cute. It says, actually, we're going to sit this right here. My phone. All right. But it says, once upon a time, there was a girl and she made all of her dreams come true. That's what this one says. And the other one says, just sparkle. So if you don't follow me on Instagram, it is _XOSparkle, okay? And if you don't follow me on YouTube, it is Keeping Up with Sparkle. Or is it Keeping Up with Princess Sparkle? One of them. But get into it. Okay, wait. So this book is a mystery. It's called Passionate Possession by Penny Jordan. This book is like one of those mystery murder, like I'm so in love with you, you can't get away from me, I own you kind of book. That I did see the whole entire collection sitting on the